Let's get into 3 John. The author begins like he did in 2 John by identifying himself as the elder. So we assume that is John again. And he writes in verse 4 a phrase that was similar to what we saw in 2 John. I have no greater joy than this, to hear that my children are walking in the truth. So this is John's writing again, 3rd little letter. And let me read verses 5 through 8. Beloved, you are acting faithfully in whatever you accomplish for the brethren, and especially when they are strangers, and they have testified to your love before the church. You will do well to send them on their way in a manner worthy of God. For they went out for the sake of the name, accepting nothing from the Gentiles. Therefore, we ought to support such men, so that we may be fellow workers with the truth. Yesterday, John warned us about encouraging liars, false teachers, in any way. And we want to avoid that because by encouraging them, we are participating in their evil deeds. Well, here's the opposite side of that coin. Here we are encouraged to support those who are speaking the truth, going out, speaking about the good news of the gospel of salvation through Jesus Christ. We do well to support them. It's a basis for our supporting of our missionaries. Financial support, prayer support, encouraging in any way that we can. So, we do well to send them on their way and to encourage them along the way. Therefore, verse 8, we ought to support such men so that we may be fellow workers with them. We may not be able to go ourselves, but as we encourage and send them, we become fellow workers with them. God bless our missionaries. They're doing a great work. Change of subject. When I was a teenager, I attended a missions conference with my father and one of his friends. I remember being in this auditorium. The speaker was speaking about, his text was one of the John letters, 1 John, 2 John, 3 John, I don't remember which. Don't remember what his topic was. But as he was speaking, I noticed that Dad's friend, sitting on the other side of my dad, was scribbling on a piece of paper. I figured that was his way of paying attention while he listened. Well, presently, as the speaker spoke on, my friend slid his piece of paper over to my dad. Dad looked at it and almost burst out laughing, showed it to me. His friend had doodled 3 rough outhouses, and he had labeled them 1 John, 2 John, and 3 John. It's funny how you remember some things that are so trivial and you forget things that are so important, isn't it? But I'll never be able to get that image out of my head. Anytime I turn to one of the 3 of John's little epistles, that image comes back to my mind. And now it's going to be stuck in your mind too. You're welcome. Well, God bless our missionaries. God bless all who are speaking the truth. Sometimes at great sacrifice, we do well to participate with them in their work.